In this session, we are going to study the secondary, tertiary and quaternary structure of proteins by taking hemoglobin as an example. In the previous video or session, we understood what is the primary structure of protein. So primary structure of protein is represented by the amino acid sequence. Now, in that session only, I told you the primary sequence, I mean the primary structure or amino acid sequence decides the secondary structure of the protein. Now let us understand what is the secondary structure. So the attraction and repulsion between the amino acids. So we know that different amino acids have different type of properties, the attraction and repulsion. So now the amino acids, some of the amino acids are positively charged, some of the amino acids are negatively charged, and some are neutral. Now, because of this difference in the properties, so amino acids either attract each other or repel each other. So some amino acids attract and some repel and some are neutral. Now the interaction, the attraction, repulsion, etc. So this interaction will result in the formation of secondary and tertiary structure in the protein. Now there are two important structures which form the secondary structure of the protein. They are the alpha helix and beta sheets. So we find two structures called alpha helix and beta sheets representing the secondary structure of the protein. Now the this here in this diagram, you can see the helix formed due to the interactions between the amino acids has resulted in a helical structure, and this is called alpha helix. Now this is the secondary structures, and in some parts of the protein it is going to produce the sheet like structure which are commonly called beta plated sheets. So throughout the length of the protein molecule, we come across many such alpha helices and beta sheet, pleated sheets. Then the tertiary structure. Now the tertiary structure is commonly called as three-dimensional shape of the entire protein. So the amino acid sequence is called the primary structure, and in between, so you find the helical structures and beta pleated sheets in the protein. They constitute the secondary structure. Now the whole protein overall will develop a three-dimensional shape. Now this three-dimensional shape is due to the alpha helix and beta sheets, and that alpha helix and beta sheet is due to the primary structure. So this three-dimensional structure which is created is called the tertiary structure. Now remember, this three-dimensional structure is unique for that particular protein. And as I already mentioned in a previous session, the three-dimensional structure of the protein is very, very important because the functioning of the protein is mainly dependent upon the shape of the protein. So any change in the shape will result in the functional change. So the protein function is affected by the change in the structure. So therefore, three-dimensional structure or the tertiary structure of protein becomes very important. Now, how this three-dimensional structure is created? It is mainly due to the interactions among the R groups, which results in the tertiary structure of the protein. Now, here it is just one diagram to show the tertiary structure of a protein. So it is different for different types of proteins. Okay. Now, lastly, there are some proteins which attain the quaternary level, which are called quaternary structure of proteins. Now, some proteins are formed from several polypeptides. There are some complex proteins which actually they are formed by many polypeptides, one or two or more than two polypeptides, and we call these polypeptides as subunits. Okay, and the interaction of all these subunits results in the quaternary structure. And in such complex proteins, the quaternary structure is the functional structure of that particular protein. Now, the quaternary structure of a protein is the association of several protein chains or subunits in closely packed arrangement. So this is what I explained in the previous slide. The protein chains, I mean the polypeptide chains, two or more than polypeptide chains come together, and there will be an interaction among these polypeptide chains. So the interaction results in a structure, and they all the subunits get packed into a common structure, and that is what we call the quaternary structure. Now each of the subunit has its own primary, secondary and tertiary structure. Now this is expected. Every polypeptide has its own primary structure, and due to the primary, a secondary structure is created, and secondary structure results in the tertiary structure. Now the subunits are held together by hydrogen bonds and van der Waals forces between non-polar side chains. Now here, to understand the quaternary structure of a protein, we normally take the example of one very commonly known protein called hemoglobin. Now we all know that hemoglobin is a pigment which is associated with the blood cell, and its main function is to transport the oxygen, and this is the protein which is responsible for the red coloration of the blood. Now it consists of two pairs of different proteins designated as alpha and beta chains. So hemoglobin is a complex protein molecule which is actually made up of two alpha chains and two beta chains. Now here chains represent a polypeptide. Now the alpha polypeptide is 141 amino acid long, and whereas the 146 amino acids constitute the beta chains. So here there is a alpha chain which is 141 amino acid long, and there is a beta chain which is 146 amino acid long. Hemoglobin molecule is actually formed by the combination of two alpha and two beta chains. So each subunit is linked covalently to a molecule of heme. So heme forms the central part to which the four subunits, the four polypeptides are attached. And the two identical alpha chains and the two identical beta chains are arranged tetrahedrally. Now this diagram shows the structure of the hemoglobin. Here you can see this is actually the quaternary structure which has resulted due to the four polypeptides. So this one and this one, they represent two beta chains, okay, which are 146 amino acid long each, and these two are alpha chains. So totally the hemoglobin molecule is made up of four polypeptide chains, two alpha and two beta subunits. And here you can see the heme group. Okay, so this is the heme group, and totally the hemoglobin molecule is formed like this. And you know the function of this hemoglobin, it's mainly involved in transportation of oxygen. So like this, protein molecules mainly depend on their structure for their function. So the amino acid sequence results in the primary structure, and the interaction between the amino acids will lead to the formation of alpha helix and beta sheets, which represents the secondary structure. And then the folding of the protein molecule, the folding of the polypeptide on its own due to the interaction among these amino acids will result in a three-dimensional structure, and this is called the tertiary structure. So in many proteins, tertiary structure itself is a functional structure. But in some complex molecules like hemoglobin, more than two polypeptides are involved in the creation of a quaternary structure which is functional. Say for example, in case of hemoglobin, the beta chain, even though it is 146 amino acid long, it doesn't have any function on its own. So alpha chain is not having any function on its own. So only when they combine like this to form a hemoglobin molecule, they become functional as a pigment molecule. So just remember, when it comes to the proteins, it is the shape of the protein which is very, very important. For example, almost all enzymes are protein molecules. Okay, and these enzymes are very sensitive to the temperature. So there are some molecules which change their shape in higher temperature. Okay, because the shape, the three-dimensional shape, is mainly due to the hydrogen bonding, the weak interaction bit among the amino acids. So at higher temperature, such bonds may be broken and there may be a change in the shape of the enzyme. So when there is a change in the shape of the enzyme, it loses its property, it loses its function. But if the temperature is reduced, it may regain its shape and again it will become functional. So this is what you have to remember. It is not the amino acid sequence, it is not the alpha helix or beta sheets, it is the tertiary, the three-dimensional structure and the quaternary structure, which is very, very important when it comes to the functioning of the protein molecules.